y'all. This is my Ava from Hell on Wheels look.
I start off by putting the Laura Geller primer all over my face. Then I use the Laura Geller Balance and Brighten Powder Foundation all over my face, but very lightly. I chose this powder because it's not too heavy and it'll let your natural skin shine through a little bit and give you that more natural look like Eva and Hell on Wheels has. Ava's nose is slightly more broad than mine is, and it's not as red as mine is, so I'm using concealer to make my nose wider and also less red. I also put some concealer on the arch of my eyebrow because Ava has very thin but predominant eyebrows and I wanted to hide some of my natural eyebrow shape. And of course I put some concealer under my eye to hide some of my under eye bags. I then put concealer all over my lips because I'm gonna change my lip shape later and I wanna have a clean slate to work with. I then add a little bit of translucent powder to blend all of the concealer in. I then line my upper waterline with a brown eyeliner, and then I cover my whole lid with a light brown eyeshadow. I realize that this part is a little bit out of focus, but what I do is I get a slightly darker brown eyeshadow, and I kind of draw out my eye line a little tiny bit to give it almost a wing so that it changes my eye shape and makes it look a little bit more almond shaped. I then go one shade darker in brown, and I line my upper lash line with it and bring it into my crease. I then use that same color that was in my crease, and I line my lower lash line with it. All of these eyeshadows are from my BH Cosmetics 120 color palette, and I just keep going down one more shade darker with the browns. Under the lash line, you're gonna wanna draw it out a little bit more, almost like you have raccoon eyes, but we're gonna fix that. We fix this by putting a little bit of powder under our eyes to shape it up and make it look a little more normal. The reason why I dragged out the color so far under my eyes is because mostly in season one, Eva has this tired, almost dirty look about her where she really does have dark under eye circles. I then went back in and put some more dark brown on my upper lash line because it was really, really light. I then started to reshape my nose. I used a contour brush and bronzer, and I made my nose a little bit wider and definitely more pronounced, and I dragged the contour color, or the bronzer, onto under my eyes, and like I would normally with a highlighter, just to give myself a little bit more of that tan look, and to continue that dark under eye bag look. Ava also in season one has a pretty pronounced smile line, so I just darkened mine a little tiny bit to make it look more pronounced. I then got a bronzer and did a slight contour of my cheekbones. Her cheekbones aren't super dark, so what I did is I went to the last molar in my mouth and I just drew a straight line back to my ear from there. I also have a very sharp pointy chin and I wanted to tone it down a little bit, so I put bronzer on the top of my chin and going back to kind of create more of a circular jaw instead of a heart-shaped one. Again, I went over it with a loose powder and tried to blend all of the contouring into my natural skin tone. I then did my eyebrows in a dark brown. What I did is I created a little bit of a circle at the start of my eyebrow, and then I did a very high, straight, thin eyebrow going back because Ava's eyebrows are very, very dark, but they're also kind of thin and kind of high. I also did a little bronzer on the tip of my nose and on my nostrils to make the tip of my nose look like it's facing down more and to make my nostrils look slightly bigger. I then got a black gel eyeliner and started to draw the tattoos that Eva has. I started by doing two at either end of my mouth and one down the middle. I then drew a line in between each of these. Eva has two sideways triangles on the outermost tattoo lines. The top one is a little bit bigger and the bottom one is smaller, so I drew in those triangles and then I colored them in to darken them. I then darkened up the lines on each of the tattoos as well to make them a little bit more thicker. Eva's tattoos mean three blankets and a horse, which is what the tribe, the Mojaves, that captured her decided she was worth. I then started working on the three middle lines. They have a little bit of a thickness to the top of them, which almost look like triangles still, so I filled in the top of them with little itty bitty triangles against my lip, and then I thickened the line and moved to the bottom of the tattoo and drew bigger triangles facing towards the middle. The bottom triangle in the middle tattoo line, I tried to make it as equal as I could so that it's not pointing towards the left or towards the right. And then for this line, I drew the triangle on the bottom facing more towards the middle, like its opposite line. And then I just went over all the lines again with a second coat to make sure that they were dark enough and thick enough. Then I did the other outer line and drew my big triangle and my little triangle and drew them in and thickened up the line. I then used Benefit Benetint on my cheeks. I smiled so that I could find the apples of my cheeks, and then I dotted it on to make it look as natural as possible, and then I dabbed it into my skin. Eva on the show is a prostitute, and during this time period, prostitutes and loose women would use a similar ruse on their cheeks, lips, and other body parts to give them that rosy look. I love this product because you can use it on your cheeks or on your lips, and it gives you just the perfect amount and still looks natural. I then used a powder highlighter in a peachy shade and put that above my cheekbone and above my jawbone to lighten them up and also make my face look a little bit more round. I then got a highlighter and put that on top of my arch and under my arch on my eyebrows to make my arch look higher and thinner. I rubbed that in with my fingers. I then wanted to put on a tiny bit of mascara, so I wiped off the mascara on my mascara tube and applied it. I then used a natural red lip gloss to reshape my lips. Eva has a slightly smaller lower lip than I do and a slightly bigger upper lip, so I covered up most of my bottom lip and applied the red and tried to make it look a little tinier, and then I overdrew my top lip. Eva has a very womanly figure, so for me to transform myself into that, I put some bronzer under my collarbone and above my collarbone and in the middle of my neck to make my collarbone pop more. And then to give myself a bigger, fuller chest like Eva has, I did a Y shape going down the center of my chest and then the Y's going towards the side of my chest to enhance my natural shape. I also put the peachy highlighter on top of my collarbone and on top of my chest to make it pop more. And that's how you give yourself an instant boob job.
Bye y'all, thanks for watching. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe or comment. And if you want to see something else, just let me know. Thank you, have a good day, bye.
For those of you watching, here's a little bit of background on Eva's character historically and the person whom her character is based off of. Eva's character is based off of a historical person named Olive Oatman. Olive and her family were traveling when they were massacred by a native tribe. Olive was captured by Yavapai Indians and then later traded to the Mojave Indian tribe, as was her sister, which is similar to the story told by Eva and Helen Wheels. Olive believed that she was tattooed to mark her as a slave, although typically people were tattooed in the tribe so that they could get a safe passage into the afterlife. Likewise, Eva believes that the tattoo on her chin is her worth, but she later confides that she thinks that possibly the tattoo was to show everyone that she was one of the tribe's people. Olive was traded for 2 horses and 3 blankets and a bunch of vegetables, but Eva claims that she was traded for 1 horse and 3 blankets. Also, Eva claims that only she herself survived the massacre, whereas Olive and her sister survived the massacre and were captured. Also, Olive's brother was part of the massacre, and the natives thought they had killed him, but he was actually okay and able to escape. Sometime after Olive and her sister were traded to the Mojave tribe and tattooed, her sister had died from starvation or illness. Olive was eventually traded for and returned back to her people and to her brother. She went on to write a memoir book called Life Amongst the Indians, which was a bestseller at the time. She then went to college, married a farmer, and had a baby girl. She also claims that she was never sexually abused by any of the natives. This is very different than Eva's claim that she was sexually abused by the tribe, and then when she was returned to her people, she became a prostitute. I hope you like this little history lesson.
And the outfit that I'm wearing is from the Jonah Hex movie, but I figured it was close enough to Hell on Wheels since it's about cowboys and the Wild West, which is basically what Hell on Wheels is about, and it's about the train. So yeah, I hope you liked it. Thank you for watching.